Some viewers may find this disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Watching Choice TV. So a lot of you guys wanted me to cover the story about Trey being exposed for being gay, bisexual, and I already knew this motherfucking information. We already knew. Trey's made it perfectly clear multiple times.
You feel what I'm saying? The question was, you know what I'm saying, is my brother gay?
Hell no! Hell no!
I'm trying to use it as to why I'm not saying that I'm gay.
I think the best thing to do is to take Trey's word if he says he's not gay. Because if he clearly says he's not gay, then he's not gay. We gotta leave it alone. See, nowadays we live in a world where people like to use things that you can't change and then use it as an insult. Like, for example, if you're Muslim, people automatically will say things like, oh yeah, well, that's why you're this and this and that. Your religion is this and this and that. Or if you're gay, people will say things like, oh yeah, well, that's why you're gay. Or if you're... If you're dark-skinned, some people are like, oh, well, that's why you're black as hell. Like, those are just examples. People use things that you can't change against you. You know, people use things that we're all labeled as against you. That just things that are a part of you, and then you get put in a bubble because of how you are and how you look. That's just the way society is. Society will make fun of you because of your race, how rich you are, your status, sexuality, religion, all that bullshit. And I think it's only safe to take Trey's word for it. I've said this before. Let's take Trey's word for it because he's not gay. Now, all to y'all shade started all of this shit. This would never happen if it weren't for all to y'all shade. For those of you guys who didn't know, all to y'all shade posted a video, and this video was the person who claimed to be in a gay relationship with Trey exposing him. This person reached out to all to y'all shade and sent all to y'all shade these screenshots and sent all to y'all shade a screen recording of them going right over to his page to make it seem like the text messages were real. So it was like, oh, okay, these seem very compelling. But then things got out of hand because Armand and Trey went on live stream and they set the record straight.
They talking about disrespect, yeah, I'm disrespecting all of them, girls and all. Bitches, what the fuck are you talking about? Oh, we got some gay shit to say. Photoshopping and shit. Get the fuck on with that gay ass shit. It's probably one of them gay ass little niggas over there too.
Y'all need to find something else better to do, bro. Like, stop photoshopping shit. Y'all want me to be gay so damn bad. Y'all want me to be like, oh, I'm gay. I'm not, bro. I got a whole ass female that I'm kicking it with right now, bro. Since y'all post... Hold on, CJ. Hold on.
All to y'all dick suckers. That's what y'all is. Fuck on. Since and I see that y'all... comment talking about, we ain't got a problem with our minor Trey. They ain't gonna comment underneath the post, underneath the YouTube, talking about, you want to get mad about something true. Shut the fuck up, dick sucking, nigga. Bro, bitch. Nah.
I'm talking about, so you want to get mad over something true.
Right. Fuck on. Honestly,
bro.
Some fucking views, bro.
Ain't no.
The one thing that stood out in that live stream was, Arm & Hammer has the ugliest personality in the fucking world. Oh my God. Like, the way he was speaking, he's over here like, suck my dick. Like, does that? Like, bitch, how old are you? Are you 7? Oh no. Like, that shit, oh, I'm about to eat these, by the way. How old are you, bitch? Like, what? Like, what type of shit is that? Like, how are you just gonna sit here and then be like, oh, suck our dicks to get the fuck out of here with that gay shit? It's like, whoa. Bitch, you're doing more damage than help. I hope you know that. Now, the thing about Arm & Hammer and Cafeteria Trey. Now, they've gone live multiple times, and that kind of rubbed me the wrong way, because it's like, why are you going on live multiple times addressing something that you've already addressed in a video? Addressing something that you've already addressed on a live stream. They went live multiple times. They're going live with fucking Peasant over here.
Stop being mad and get you a bag.
Stop being mad.
Stop being mad and get you a bag.
less worried about Arm & Hammer cafeteria trend. I think she should be more worried about the fact that she's not wearing her fucking wedding ring. But I feel like this. I see, like, Altiache definitely fueled all this only because they paid any mind to that person who sent those probably fake receipts. Because the thing is, what you guys don't realize is this. So, the screen recording that Altiache received seemed almost legit. But the thing about that screen recording was, okay, yeah, you can't deny a screen recording. Arm & Hammer, Captain Trey, like, it's Photoshop, Photoshop. But I'm like, bitch, you can't Photoshop a screen record. Okay? So then, the funny thing is, this is what happened. Martin Lewis actually debunked this. And he made it perfectly clear that that screen recording right here is clearly, clearly edited. Y'all see how the eye is blinking? The person went to my Instagram and look at it, look. You see how the eye is blinking? The eye blinks when you click on it. The person repeatedly clicked on it and showed me what happens when you click on the messages. See, you click on the little eye right here. Look at it, look at that shit. Click on the eye and then boom, it takes you over to my info. Then you go over to my Instagram. But in the clip that the person who claimed to be in a relationship with Trey, he clearly showed only him going over to the info thing and then jump cut, going over to cafeteria trace page. This person clearly graduated from DMB University. So this person's clearly trying to fool us and an Altiache shade fell for it. I love y'all, Altiache. Y'all cool. Y'all showed me love before. But I'm gonna have to come for y'all real quick. They over here deleting videos because they want to delete an audio of this person who's in a gay relationship with Trey. And then they deleted it. This is the audio.
Okay, I really don't have much to say. All I have to say is this. Stop trying to play me like you don't know who I am, because you know exactly who I am. And stop blaming that page because they didn't do it. I did, and you know exactly who I am. And you blocked me yesterday, so I already screen recorded it and typed out your name and everything and went on your profile. So you're not about to try to play me like you don't know who I am, and you're not about to try to act like you can keep pretending if you want to. Everybody already know about you. So this is just what I'm have to say. You made that weak ass live video. It was weak as fuck. Well, I don't know. Why would you make a live video when your brother pumping you up in the background as usual? Like when we get on the phone and everything, when he pumping you up and being loud and boisterous in the background for no fucking reason as usual. I don't understand why he was even back there doing that. And you can hide from him all you want to. You can hide from the rest of your family all you want to, but you already know what it is. So like, I'm not even about to sit here and go back and forth with you. So like, this is not no reason for me to do that.
Why y'all deleting shit? So this audio right here that y'all over here deleting, and it's clearly showing that the only reason y'all deleted it is because y'all starting to catch on and think, oh, my bad, we actually posted some fake ass receipts. All to y'all shit. Y'all cool and everything, but y'all credibility is on the line. You can't be doing that, because me, funny story, let me give y'all some tea real quick. The person who claimed to be in a relationship with Trey, they for a second had me fooled. But the thing is, I refused to do the story. I didn't want to do the story. I didn't want to address it. They reached out to me, Altiache, Martin Lewis, and Altiache was the only person who covered the story. I wasn't trying to cover shit. I wasn't trying to cover shit because there wasn't enough tangible evidence. I want to see you sucking Trey's dick pictures. No, let me stop. I want to see pictures of you kissing Trey, hugging Trey. Show me more than just messages, screen recording. Show me more. Show me more. Show me something. Who knows? Trey could have been drunk when he messaged you. Who knows? This all could have been fake, but they found a way to work around it. I want to see more receipts. Show me pictures of you FaceTiming him. Send me videos of y'all FaceTiming. Show me something. Because the screen, this audio right here, it wasn't adding up. He was over here like, oh, and for all y'all little kids who say it's fake, well, it's not. So we just gonna take your word for it, bitch? You gotta come with the receipts nowadays because bitches over here be lying. Like, motherfuckers be lying. And it kind of made me not think the person was lying because this person clearly stated, I'm not doing this for clout, so I don't want to show my name. So that's where it's like, okay, yeah, so clearly this person isn't doing it for clout, but maybe this person just doesn't like Trey, cafeteria Trey, just said, hey, fuck it, let's try to ruin this person's reputation. And all to y'all say, later uploads an apology video when everything starts to unfold because Trey uploaded this video to his channel.
Anyways, it's all fake, y'all. And I know y'all like, well, how is it fake and it's a screen recording and this, and that. How you can't fake screen recording, this, and that. It's all true, this, and that. It's fake, y'all. It's fake. That's how I receive. That's how you receive and make it look like, look, that's how you make it look like me. What they did was, you see this? Y'all see this? Trey trailer right there. And they put my photo, they screenshotted my photo. And when it say add photo, they added my photo to theirs to make it look like that. You know what I'm saying? That's what they did. It's different apps that you can use for this, because I seen it. Y'all just seen Instaprank.
Now, Trey is a fucking idiot. He didn't really prove much. Frankly, I proved more. Martin Lewis proved more than he proved. Like, clearly there was a jump cut based off of what I showed you. From when I click on the eye, it dims down when you go on the person's info, then go on their page. That person click on the eye and boom, you all of a sudden, you don't see the little eye in the corner dim its color, you know? You don't see that shit dim. So, the fact that Trey is over here trying to prove his case multiple times, it kind of makes it look more suspect because it's like, okay, Trey, you addressed it multiple times, you told everybody that you're not gay, why the fuck you keep addressing this shit? Shut your ass up, okay? You said you're not gay, you've addressed it in the video, you've addressed it in your first live stream. Why are you coming forth? And Arm & Hammer, annoying ass, keep jumping in shit. That shit is so fucking annoying. And I understand you're sticking up for your brother and shit, but he was making me cringe in every single live stream. I'm like, nigga, shut up, shut your ass up.
Hey, let's change the subject with our rich asses.
Like, he's over here like, now let's get back to being rich. Bitch, subscribe just to unsubscribe. What type of shit is that? That really rubbed me the wrong way. Let Trey handle this, okay? Trey is a big boy. He's grown. He can handle this. Now, the thing is, when Trey was trying to, you know, show that all y'all here was posting fake receipts, he showed how it could be done. But the thing is, he didn't show anything that was too reliable because he showed that with every message bubble, you see the person's name above it. He said, it's not like that. He said, that's how you know it was fake. But the thing is, this person screen recorded. So this leads me to think that maybe the person screen recorded the messages and then boom, cut out the part where they X out of the screenshot, the fake screenshot, and then went right over to Instagram to make it seem like they jumped over to his Instagram page. So that makes me feel like, okay, clearly they screen recorded the screenshot, pressed the home button, went right over to Instagram, and then clicked on Trey's page. But it was a jump cut trying to fool us. That's what editing is. Bitch be trying to be on some slick shit, trying to be on some shady shit. This person DM'd me, and I was on their side at first, but when they couldn't show me no receipts, I wasn't really with it. They claimed, oh, I have his new number. I'm like, okay, give me his number. We can call his ass right now. Look what's good. The nigga ain't hit me back. So clearly, if you ain't hitting me back, give me his number, what's going on, what's good. You clearly not who you say you are. At the end of the day, Trey said he's straight. So, we gotta take his word for it. Could these messages be real? Shit. Maybe, maybe not. But there's no tangible evidence there's no foundation under this conundrum to hold everything up. There's no foundation holding it. There's no legs under this chair to hold everything up and support this theory that Trey is gay. So at the end of the day, we all gotta come to the conclusion that Trey is not gay. He's made it clear. He said that he has a whole female that he's kicking it with. So, as far as we all know, we just gonna have to take Trey's word for it. And also, y'all say posting an apology video just has me like, okay, I don't really understand why they're apologizing. Because, for one, you guys are a gossip. Like you guys are in the shade room, but for YouTube, for black YouTube. You guys are in the shade room, but for YouTube and for YouTubers. I don't really understand why you guys are apologizing. I understand that you guys posted some receipts and you were on their side at first. But at the end of the day, you guys are a gossip account and you guys are a tea account. You guys don't personally make these things up. You just post what is sent to you. At the end of the day, if y'all apologize, shit, bitch, do you. Y'all, hopefully y'all grow. Do you. But at the end of the day, you should have covered the story. As drama channels, as tea channels, Mario Lewis knows this, I knows this, so many other people know this, even your rage. You can't be, like we get receipts and messages sent to us all the time. Like, people who know these YouTubers personally, people who know people like Ashley Ortega, people who know people like Mystic or Nate's Life personally, they be like fucking DM me saying, hey, I know T on this person and I hang out with this person, blase, blase. But I get shit like that all the time, and I'm not going to believe shit unless you come through, and you show me some tangible evidence that you know this bitch. That you somehow have some relation with this bitch and how somehow what you're saying is true. Okay? Because bitches nowadays be fucking lying. So I'm going to need more than just screenshots or screen recording. And this clearly shows that screen recordings can be somehow fraudulent. Now, what really runs me the wrong way about this story is the fact that Arm & Hammer and Cafeteria Trey are promoting it. Why are they talking about it? Why are they speaking on it? Why are they giving this more situation gas? Why are they gassing this shit up? Why are they fueling this up? Are they fueling this up and even making a video on their on their channel to some way somehow provide to everyone that he's not gay? Why is he constantly coming on social media and giving everybody validation like, oh, I'm not gay. Like, bitch, we heard you the first time, we heard your second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Why are you gassing the situation, giving this more fuel? It's not making no sense to me. This is just some messy ass bullshit. I really wish Altia Shea would have looked more into this before posting it. I don't really understand why they're deleting shit. Like, why y'all deleting shit? Why y'all disabling the comments? I don't understand. But hey, at the end of the day, you can't be posting every fucking thing. Like, I'm not gonna lie, sometimes Altia Shea, y'all would just post any damn thing. And yeah, that's that. Please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Comment what you want to see next. Add me on Snapchat, add me on Instagram. And yeah, that's that. Choice out this bitch. You ain't about that ratchet life. Lies till the morning light. Still putting up a fight.